696 running over I-75. Volume's building just a little bit, but still not as heavy as a normal weekday morning. And also taking a look at M39 Southfield near Warren, where we have traffic picking up more there, but still not a big slowdown. No problems at that site. Let's head up now to Sky Fox. Bill Schmancy, got a bunch of vehicles bunched up. Where is this?
This is Southfield Road over here, north of I-696, where we did have the earlier accident scene. Everything has been cleared out of the way here, and all lanes have been reopened. The delays are pretty much gone as well. Just your typical heavy volumes. Back in Temple.
Well, fix it up, clean it up, or tear it down. That is the ultimatum of the city of Trenton and what they're giving to the owner of the Riverside Hospital. It's been abandoned for more than a decade and left open to the elements, scrappers, and thrill seekers. Neighbors say it has been an eyesore for years, and the city cannot move fast enough to do something about it. The owner planned to turn it into an assisted living facility. He applied to the state to make that happen, but that was 3 years ago.
It's funny because today the state of Michigan called and wanted to know if the project here, the hospital, was finished and where the report was. Mm-hmm. And so, coincidence today that happens, and I said the project has not even been started. The promises have been made and then not kept, and the promises have been made and not kept, and I can't understand for the life of me why something isn't being done here.
The Dangerous Building Board will have 5 days to decide whether the owner will have to fix that up or tear it down.
Detroit is working hard to eliminate blighted neighborhoods. In fact, the demolition of old and abandoned homes and buildings in the city is on the fast track. City officials say the effort has not been hampered by many recent reports of squatters inside some of those structures.
Detroit as a whole may have some issues with squatting, but we're not seeing it in the demolition process. In the past several months, we've done over 3,000 structures. We've increased the pace of demo from 200 a month to 200 a week.
All this demolition means job opportunities. Anyone looking for work should contact Detroit Employment Solutions. The number is on your screen right now, 313-962-9675. That on our website as well. Also, people living next to the newly cleared lot can actually buy the property for only $100.
You could soon be able to get a bird's eye view of downtown Detroit. I like this idea. It is part of an update plan to the Penobscot building. Half of